Hello, good morning class. Today is 6th of July. We are dealing with the chapter primary sector. So the topic of the day is food security. We'll deal with what the food security is and why do we need to secure ourselves as far as food is concerned. And what percentage of the country, what percentage of India is basically food secured? Means food secured when I say they do not need to worry about, they do not need to think about two basic meals of the day. Two times meals they are not worried about. Means their income level, their earning capacity is so high that they are not bothered about the meal process or the food security. But there are certain percentages of population which actually could not or cannot fulfill their basic needs, cannot fulfill their two times meals a day. Those people need a special attention of the government. The government have come up with various benefit programs just to help them, just to be a part of them, just to create a helping hand for them so that they can be a part for the country. They can be an asset for the country. So this topic we are going to see what food security is, what does the word food security mean, and who are the people who are food insecure, what population of the country is food insecure, in what manner, and the last three, the steps which the government have been taking from the 1947 onwards or from the first 5-year plan onwards, what steps the government have been taking or provoking. We'll see the achievements of those steps and what are the milestones that the government has achieved till date. So I'll come up with the meaning of food security. Now say India has been facing food crisis since a long period. Food crisis or food insecurity is not a new term, it's not a new problem for India. But it's from since a very long time, from before the independence even, we were food starving, we were not having our 2 meals a day. So it is a big problem for the growing country like India. So in order to capitalize, in order to utilize every part of the population, it requires a proper and sufficient amount of food. Nutritional food, does not only need food, but a nutritional food, a balanced food, which could actually create economy blessed with the assets for the development of the economy. An economy which is blessed with healthy people are basically the assets for the economy. It says during the Second World War, India experienced a severe food crisis, leading to sharp rise in the prices of food grains. Now, whenever there is a war, whenever there is an unnatural event, or whenever there is a call from the nature, it actually destructs everything. War does not bring any harmony. War, more or less, it actually destroys the peace and harmony of the common people. And the sufferers are basically the marginalized sections of the society who are not in a position to fulfill their basic needs. So the war cannot be or can never be a solution to any problem. So when the Second World War took place, during that time only India went up to a sharp decline in its food imports or food production, which actually created a problem for the major part of the population. And which further led to rise in the price of food grains. Again in 1943, Bengal faced a serious famine where nearly 35 lakh people died of starvation. Starvation is when who is not able to fulfill the basic needs or basic consumption needs of a human body. The partition of India in 1947 again aggravated the food crisis, as the country had to forego the food surplus areas of West Punjab and Sindh. The partition again created a problem for India, and some of the major producing parts, some of the major area where a lot of productions were done, where a lot of food crops were grown, that was to be left, because after partition, those areas did not belong to us, but moreover it belonged to our neighboring countries. So that actually created a problem for this new country called India. In order to tackle the situation, the government undertook measures from time to time, such as, now government have been taking various measures just to fulfill the gap, so that none of the population or no part of the population remains empty stomach or does not get a proper meal or does not remain healthy. So government have been taking various steps, like for example, rationing system. Ration card was issued from very early onwards. Rationing system, nationalization of whole trade in food grains. Whole trade was nationalized. So that nationalized, it means the government undertook it. It was under the venture of the government only. Government was a decider about the rates, and all the rates were prescribed under the Government of India monopoly. So nationalization means when some ventures are taken away or accepted by the government, that becomes a nationalized part of the country. Organization of food zones for purchase of food grain from surplus zone and transferring them to deficit zones, etc. Now there are two areas basically, one which blessed with surplus food crops, the other is in a deficit. Now those two areas need to be mitigated, needs to be maintained. Means wherever the surplus production is there, those surplus production should be transferred to the area where the deficit production is there. Means where no production takes place. This is what we do. How do we create a demand in the market? We create a demand because at some place there are heavy amount of production is done. At some place there is demand is there, but no supply is there. So that place actually shifts, that place actually transfer the all the surplus production to the deficit place, because this place creates a heavy demand for so and so product. So this one time during the time of independence also, when the food crisis was there, the surplus production area had to transfer to those areas which actually lacked or wherever the deficit was going on. However, India needs a food security system which goes beyond the management of food supply only. Now all these steps that we talked about now, rationing system or wholesale trade price was fixed, these all are done or from transferring from surplus to deficit area. Now these all steps does not give a security of food. These all steps does not give a security of food to the marginalized sections of the society. It is basically when the food crops are produced, they can be transferred, they can be moved from one place to the other place. But who will buy? The person who have the earning capacity, means those who have a good economic system, can only be a part of this transferring, or can only be a part of this change. But what about those who are very marginal, who are below the poverty line? The government has to think about them because they are part of the population and they are an asset for the economy. If you do not think about them, they might turn out to be liability for the economy. So here the food security does not only means transferring of food items from surplus areas to deficit areas, but it has a bigger concept. The bigger concept is that every part of the population, everyone in the country should get 2 times a meal that requires a basic fulfillment of food supply to everybody. All the nutritional values should be transferred or should be given to every individual. So, we'll see the definition or meaning of food security, what it means actually. Now, food is an essential for living and air for breathing. As air is required for breathing, same food is required for living. If you want to live, food is an essential element. But food security means something more than getting 2 square meals. When you are getting more than 2 square meals, or when you want to get 2 square meals, that means we need to be food secure. So, food security can be defined as the ability to ensure on a long-term basis that the food provides the entire population access to enough food for an active and healthy life. I repeat, food security can be defined as, we are seeing the definition of food security, or how can you define food security? So food security can be defined as the ability to ensure on a long-term basis. It's not a matter of one day, it's not a matter of short-term, but it's a long-term concept. The government has to think, okay, if the population needs to get active population, if the population needs to be an asset for the economy, they need to be fed for a longer term. Food security can be defined as the ability to ensure on a long-term basis that the food system provides the entire population access to enough food for an active and healthy life. It is very much essential for an active and healthy life. The moment you are healthy, the moment you are active, then only you can give your best. We even call it as an active or a healthy mind or a healthy soul is the need of time. That means if you are healthy, then only you can get your 100%. FAO is an organization, Food and Agricultural Organization, which actually defines the definition of, or which actually gives the definition of food security as ensuring that all people at all times, not one time, at all times have both physical and economic access to basic food they need. Now, physical and economic access means over here, physical means that is available at your place or at your venture, wherever you put up, that is available. Means if a physical communication is made, you are able to achieve that food items. Economic access means that you have the purchasing power. In economics we call, we do not call it how much money you earn or what is your earning capacity, but we call it as purchasing power. If a person has that purchasing power, that means his living standard is good, his earning capacity is good. So economic access here means that the fellow, the person or the population or the society has the purchasing power, should have the purchasing power, then only they can be a part of the system. Thus, the food security has the following essential components. Now, there are certain essential components that food security bears. First is, food security involves the availability of sufficient quantity and good quality food. It is not just the supply of food, it is not just the delivery of food, but a good quality of food is the need of the time. A good quality of food. Good quality of food means which is full of nutritional value. Nutritional value is very high, then when it is said to be of good quality. The second point says, people have enough purchasing power, that is adequate resources, so that they can acquire food they need. The access to food depends not only on household income, but also on food prices. Now there are two things that you need to understand in a market. When you go to a market, you need to understand two basic things. The first is the supply of the product. Second is your purchasing power. If the supply of the product is ample, that means you need to have increase your earning capacity. Then only you can be a part of. Now there is another concept of law of demand, which we will be studying in the next class, class 10. It says, now why am I explaining this concept? Because law of demand, there is a law which says that more is demanded at lower prices. More can be only demanded when the prices are low, and vice versa, means less is demanded at high prices. And there are some exceptions to this divide even. There are some cases where the law of demand does not work. But what I want to explain you over here, anything can only be demanded when its price is low.
on a general basis. Whenever the price of the item or the goods is low, that is demanded more. So whenever the supply is more, whenever the supply of food crop is more and the price is at marginal level or at low level, then only it can be purchased or it can be demanded on a higher level. The third point says, food security necessitates timely, reliable and nutritionally adequate supply of food on a long-term basis. I told you a nutritional value should be there. Nutritional value is an important aspect of food crop. So that should be present over there. And second is, it should be on a longer term basis. Supplying of any food items should not be for a shorter duration, but moreover, it should be for a longer term basis. It is not the matter of one or two days, but on a regular basis, that too with a proper nutritional value. And the last point is, it also necessitates maintaining a buffer stock so as to take care of natural calamities resulting in temporary shortages. Now, one term that we need to understand, I think I have explained you this. The term is buffer stock. Buffer stock. Buffer stock is nothing much but the additional stock or the reserve that you maintain at your house or in your business venture. Whatever surplus you produce for a particular year and whatever is left after the consumption, after the sales, after the satisfaction of the population, whatever remaining is there, that becomes a buffer stock or that becomes an additional stock for the next year or for the progressive years. So the point says, it also necessitates maintaining a buffer stock. Buffer stock should be maintained. Now why is it so? The relation you will understand, if you are an earner of your father or if your parents are an earner, do they spend everything whatever they earn? If suppose for example, I earn to pay 10,000 on a monthly basis, do I spend everything that I earn? Or do I keep it something for my future needs or for some uncertainties? Do I keep some sort of reserve? So whatever reserve I keep, that becomes a buffer stock for me. First thing. Now the question is, why do we maintain a buffer stock? The maintenance of buffer stock is basically for the purpose of because India is a tropical, India has a tropical climate and natural calamity is a part of this system only. So it can take place at any point of time. Sometimes there is no rain, sometimes the land goes dry. So just to maintain the order, just to maintain the equilibrium, what we do, we maintain a buffer stock. So, like for example, in the year 2020, there is a heavy rain and there is a good rainfall over here. The crop productions are done in ample amount. But next year we do not know what is going to take place or how the weather is going to take part. If the weather does not support the farmers, how are they going to produce? What are they going to cultivate? So, well, the need of the population stock. Okay, this year no cultivation has been done, so we do not need to eat anything. Can it be done? It cannot be done. So in order to fulfill those needs, we need to maintain some sort of buffer stock. Since this year we are having surplus production, so we will keep it as a stock and that stock will be referred as buffer stock. The concept of food security as discussed above has been mostly of making it available a minimum quantity of food grains to the entire population. I told you the minimum basic needs of everyone should be fulfilled. Then only every part of the population will be involved, they will be a part of the system and they will be an asset for the economy. Now, but this seems to be a narrow concept. In a dynamic and a developing economy, the concept of food security undergoes a change with the stage of development reached by the society. Therefore, the following stages of food security may be looked upon. Now, there are certain stages of food security. सब स्टेजेस आते हैं व्हिच सोसाइटी टू सोसाइटी कंट्री टू कंट्री वेरी फिर इन आवर केस व्हाट इज द फूड सिक्योरिटी और व्हाट आर द स्टेजेस ऑफ फूड सिक्योरिटी इज द फर्स्ट स्टेज इज टू मेक एन एडिक्वेट क्वांटिटी ऑफ सीरियल्स अवेलेबल टू ऑल पीपल फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल नाउ एडिक्वेट क्वांटिटी ऑफ सीरियल्स इज necessary is required because it totally depends upon the climate where we are putting up or where we are living up. So our body, our environment demands a lot of intake of cereals. So cereals requirement is high over here. The second is, in the second stage we may think of food security in terms of adequate availability of cereals and pulses. These are basic nutritional food items. Required by the body, even the doctors, advisors to take these in or add these as a part of the food on a daily basis. The third stage, food security should include cereals, pulses, milk, and milk products. These are the part again which after satisfying the need, which after fulfillment of the basic hunger, there are some additional value which your body should intake. That is for the proper development of the whole system. And finally, food security should include cereals, pulses, milk and milk products, vegetables and fruit, fish, eggs and meat. Now these are the stages or these are the products or these are the food items which our body actually demands. See, in India, as far as food security is concerned, what are we getting over here? We get over here rices, we get over here pulses, we get over here wheat, we get over your sugar, we get over your kerosene oil, but are we paid this? Are we given this supply of meat, egg or basic vegetable items? So this is the demand of the situation that in order to make a population healthy, in order to make a population an asset, in order to make a population active, these are the basic requirements which the country should follow on a stricter basis. Through stages, there are different stages that we have studied now, first, second, third, fourth, which every level should be developed, so then only the population will be a healthy population. Because this was about food security, the meaning of food security, our second topic for the day is, who are the people who are food insecure? I'll just a small intro only and then we'll wrap it up. The point says what? Who are food insecure people or who needs food security or basically. Although a large section of people suffer from food and nutritional insecurity in India, the most affected groups of the are the landless people. Landless people are people with little land to depend upon, traditional artisans, providers of traditional services, basically barbers, cobblers, petty self-employed workers and destitute including beggars. In the urban areas, the food insecure people are those who are generally employed in a very low paid jobs or occupations. These workers are largely engaged in seasonal activities and are paid very low wages. See, those who are not able to fulfill their basic needs, those who are not able to arrange two square meals are a part of food insecurity. The question is, who are food insecure? Those who are not able to. They want to, but they are not able to. Why they are not able to? Because they do not have the purchasing power, they do not have a good job, they are not involved in any profession, so that they are the liability for the economy. So all those people who are the liability for the economy or who cannot fulfill their basic needs, two square meals a day, they are a part of food insecurity. Now this is again categorized on the caste basis, SC, ST, OBC, these are categorized as because they are the sufferer ones, the marginalized farmers, marginal sections of the society, the artisan workers, the petty workers, these are the people who are basically starving out, who are basically fighting out to fulfill their basic needs. These people are food insecure. I put a stop over here and tomorrow we will see the food security measures. What are the food security measures that the government of India have been taking? the government has taken till date. Thank you, class.